We've surveyed 100 people. Top 7 answers on the board. Name something a son-in-law does to impress his in-laws.
Marries the wife.
Marries the wife?
Yes.
Marries the wife.
Good answer.
Buys gifts.
Buys gifts.
Steve.
Let's go, man. John Paul, how you doing, man?
I'm good, Uncle Steve.
Good, brother. What do you do?
I work for my dad in the family business. I'm the commercial manager of our food processing company.
Food processing company. That's good, man. Entrepreneur.
Yeah.
Yeah, your father paved the way.
Yes, he
did. His son, young Jung Paul, is going to take over one day.
Yes, true.
Do you have older brothers?
Yes, these are all my brothers, Uncle Steve.
Oh, all brothers?
All brothers, Uncle Steve.
Oh, who's the oldest?
This one.
He's the oldest.
Yeah.
So in your family, if he's the oldest, is he next in line to take over the company?
Uncle Steve, no, I think it's about who behaves better in the family.
Based on merit.
He's not behaving so good.
He's good.
Yes. Is he involved in the family
business? Oh, yeah, he is.
All of you in the family business?
All of us in the family business.
Oh, okay. I like that, man. I like that. That's good, brother. So, John Paul, introduce everybody.
So, these are all my brothers. This is Charles, Ernest, and Vincent.
Good. Charles, what do you do?
I'm a banker by profession, but I'm the head of operation for the business.
Oh.
The family business. I'm married and I have 3 girls.
3 girls?
Mm-hmm. Uncle Steve, I'm also married. And I got 3 girls too.
You forgot to mention that.
We're making babies, Uncle Steve.
How old are your daughters? Babies.
6, 5, and 1.
5, 3, and 1.
Can I tell you something? I have 4 daughters. You have no idea the pain you are going to be in. You have no idea the sheer agony. Now, they are the light of my life.
Yeah, that's it. True.
They are my little princes.
Yeah.
And they all have me wrapped around their finger.
True.
I give my daughters anything they ask me for.
Yeah.
I don't care what it is, I give it to them. Money, give it to them. They want a car, I give it to them. You know why? Because I don't want them asking no boy for nothing.
That's true. You're right, Steve.
All right, man, let's play the game. Name something a son-in-law does to impress his in-laws.
Give her children.
What?
Children.
Give her children.
Say this up there. Good answer.
Ernest, how you doing?
I'm good, thank you.
What do you do?
Marketing manager for our real estate division.
Marketing manager.
Yes, please.
You work out?
Oh, yes.
Yeah, I can see.
Yes.
Very well structured. Are you married?
Yes, please.
Yes, please. Yes.
And yes. I do have a son.
You have a son?
Yes.
Oh, he is here. Boy, how old is he?
4.
All right, man, let's play. Name something a son-in-law does to impress his in-laws.
Well, in our culture, you're supposed to build them a house.
Build them a house.
Yes.
Remember what we said at the beginning of the game, that I think that women are traditionally better for the fish. You told me no way.
Steve, we just started.
Well, you got 2 strikes. You just started and you already got 2 strikes.
Steve, we didn't
talk, to 2 people and we got 2 strikes. That's all I'm saying. Vincent, how you doing?
I'm good, Uncle Steve.
Yeah, what do you do?
I'm a chartered accountant by profession. I'm the director of finance for the group.
Yeah, Steve. We got it all in the family.
One of you are the youngest.
He's the youngest.
Yes, you are the youngest. You married?
No.
Oh, here we go.
Are you sure?
Are you sure? He is not married yet, but she is watching.
Depends on the time zone, Uncle Steve.
Huh?
Which time zone you're talking about, Uncle Steve?
Depends on what time zone. Yeah. Okay, player. Yeah. Okay. Now, your brothers are married.
Yes.
What are you looking for in a woman?
Loyalty will be the overarching attribute I look for in a woman.
Overarching attribute. Oh, I love this boy. I love this dude right here.
Well spoken.
Loyalty would be the overarching attribute. Oh, I've never looked for a wife like that. I am looking for someone with the overarching attribute.
Because I'm just, loyalty is the most important thing.
Loyalty, yeah. So what should she look like? What do you like?
So I like a bit of bright girl, you know, keep the room bright.
The blacker the berry.
The blacker the berry, the sweeter the juice.
I'm not really a juice person, I'm just
What?
I'm not really a juice person. You know what? You can't get mad at somebody who want what they want. All right, we got to play, so now listen to me. We got two strikes. We got to be careful. Long family can steal. Name something a son-in-law does to impress his in-laws.
Okay, Steve, well, I haven't been a son-in-law before, but I'm going to go with visit them more often.
Visit them.
Good answer, good answer.
More
good
often. Answer. Well, fellas, name something a son-in-law does to impress his in-laws.
Kill them, Lloyd. Okay. Kill them.
Kill them.
Yes.
In-laws really like a son-in-law who comes for family events, who attends family events.
Good answer. Good answer.
Family events.
Great answer. Great answer, Lloyd.
One answer. Number 7.
Buy food.
6.
Affection.
5.
Dresses well.
Number 4.
This girl is wise.
3.
Gives money.
2.
Respectful.
Surveyed 100 people. Top 7 answers on the board. Name something a doctor would tell you to avoid.
Milk.
Milk.
Salt.
Salt. Richard.
I think my doctor would tell me to avoid smoking.
Good answer.
Smoking. Pass the play.
Thanks. New play.
Good. Lloyd, how you doing, man?
I'm doing good, Steve.
What do you do for a living?
I'm a public servant at one of our state institutions.
A public servant for a state institution?
Yes.
What? What you clapping for? You don't even know what that is. Let's at least find out what this is. You be clapping for this dude? You don't even know what he do. I'm a public servant for a public institution. The hell is that? So what is your position called?
Okay, I'm currently the head of a pre-audit unit in one of their departments. We actually pay pensions.
Pensions?
Yes.
I understand perfectly. You single, married?
I'm married.
Married?
Yes.
Yes.
I actually have 3 kids and I'm expecting a 4th.
Oh, my man. My man. What do you have?
I have a boy, 2 girls, and I'm expecting another girl.
Another girl?
Yes.
Yeah, they got 3 girls, 3 girls.
Yes. At least I have a boy, so.
Yeah, you have a boy. So that's good. Yeah. You know what? It's a lot of good men up here. Married, taking care of their kids. That's good, man. That's good to see. All right? Introduce everybody.
Okay, so I have Mubarak. He's a sales professional. And then there's Richard. Richard works with a plumbing company. And then Sule is also a sales professional.
Oh, okay, good. Richard, how you doing?
I'm good. How
plumber.
Are you doing, Steve? No, I'm not a plumber, Steve.
That's what he said.
Yeah,
He just said, Richard, they plumber.
No. I said he works with a plumbing company.
Yeah, oh, he works with a plumbing company.
Yes.
Oh, you're not a plumber.
I'm not a plumber.
You work with the plumbing company.
Yeah.
Okay, so what do you do?
So I'm the administrator. I handle admin stuff and finance.
Oh, you the boss.
Not really. I'm getting there.
You're getting there?
I'm getting there.
Are you married?
No, I'm not married. I'm looking for a wife, like a regular.
You're looking for one?
Yeah.
Yeah. What are you looking for?
I'm a very nice lady, slim, tall.
Slim, tall, yeah. Would you want another you?
No. I'm skinny. I want something not too skinny.
Oh, he said, I'm skinny. I want something not too skinny. Yeah, you want a woman.
Yeah.
Something to hold.
Hey,
Sule, Steve. What's up, baby?
I'm good.
My man, what do you do for a living?
So I work with a telecoms company.
Uh-huh.
I'm an account manager.
Right.
Do connectivity stuff, internet, cloud solutions, all those fancy stuff.
Oh, that's good. Yeah. You know what, man? We have got some fine young men on this stage today, man.
I am fine.
Hardworking.
I am fine.
Yes, nice. Yes, you are. Sule said, I am fine. Yes, please. Name something a doctor would tell you to avoid.
My doctor would certainly tell me to avoid drinking.
Drinking. Something a doctor would tell you to avoid.
My doctor would tell me to avoid fatty foods.
Fatty foods.
Good answer.
Whoa, whoa. Mubarak, what do you do?
I'm also a sales professional. So what we do is try to provide lunch services to various corporate institutions.
Yeah. You know, he looks like he could be in my family. All I need is some glasses and do like this.
Let's see.
Smile really hard. I'm telling you, man. We could be in the same family. He looked like one of my cousins. That's good, man. They are going to help me with my DNA here in Africa because I know nothing about where I'm from. My father's father was a slave, so there's no records. I am looking for someone in Africa who looks just like me.
Oh, then you just found one. You just found one.
I may have found him. All right, my man. Name something, we have no strikes, that a doctor would tell you to avoid.
Steve, I'm gonna go with pressure, giving yourself undue pressure.
Pressure? You avoid stress and pressure, you cannot be successful. You have to get under pressure, severe pressure. I don't know no other way, I wish. Hey, man, we rolling. We got no strikes. Richard, we back on you again, man. Name something a doctor would tell you to avoid.
My doctor would tell me to avoid too much sugar.
Too much sugar! Sule.
Steve.
Name something a doctor would tell you to avoid.
My doctor would say I should not be lazy about. I should be more energetic. That's what my doctor would tell me.
More energetic?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
I shouldn't avoid being lazy.
Avoid being lazy. Avoid being lazy. Lloyd, we only got one strike, man. Give me something your doctor would tell you to avoid.
My doctor would tell me to avoid going without sleep.
Try to get more sleep. All right, now we got a situation. We got two strikes. We have to be careful. See if a more family can steal. They look ready. Name something a doctor would tell you to avoid.
I'm gonna go with drugs.
Good answer.
Avoid drugs. Fellas, I gotta tell you, you're playing good, man. Now the last one is a tough one to get, because very few people said it. So I ain't mad at you if you missed this, but be careful, because you got two strikes they can steal. Name something a doctor would tell you to avoid.
Steve, I think I have no option than to say. Too much sex.
Too much sex.
Good answer, good answer.
So, Richard?
Yeah, Steve.
Why would a doctor, why do you think a doctor would say avoid having too much sex? What do you think?
Probably
he's...
can't concentrate on doing other stuff, which are important.
He said, he said, you probably can't concentrate on doing nothing else. You ain't lying, Richard. You be in a world of trouble. But it sure is good, though. Well, too much sex!